If you don't get this classic joke, by the end of this episode you should. Today I explain how to convert binary to decimal and back again here at the House of Hacks. Hi makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers, Harley here. In the last two episodes of Bits of Binary, I introduced alternate number systems in general and the binary system in particular. Next, I showed you how you can use binary to count much higher than 10 on just your fingers. I closed with a question: how high can you count in binary on both hands? If you came up with an answer 1023, you really understand the basics. In this episode in the series, I'm going to show how to convert from binary to decimal and from decimal to binary. Last time, I explained how each column in a number is the base number raised to a power times the value of the column. That sounds more complicated than it is. In our familiar base 10, or decimal system, the columns are 10 to the 0, 10 to the 1, 10 to the 2, and so forth. This gives us columns that represent units, tens, hundreds, and so on. To get a specific number, say 123, you simply multiply the number in the column by the column's value, or 100 times 1, plus 10 times 2, plus 1 times 3. Applying this principle to binary, the columns are 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, and so forth, giving us 1, 2, 4, 8, and on up. So let's convert from binary to decimal. What's the decimal value of the number 10101? Given that each column represents a power of 2 and each column can only have a value of 01, this means its value is 2 to the 4 times 1, plus 2 to the 3 times 0, plus 2 to the 2 times 1, plus 2 to the 1 times 0, plus 2 to the 0 times 1. Removing the items multiplied by 0 gives us 2 to the 4 times 1, plus 2 to the 2 times 1, plus 2 to the 0 times 1. Evaluating the exponents gives us 16 times 1, plus 14 times 1, plus 1 times 1. And this all simplifies to 16 plus 4 plus 1, or 21 in decimal. Now that we know the theory, let's look at some shortcuts. Instead of looking at the columns as 2 to a power, we can look at them with specific values. Starting with the units column, we know it's 1. Each subsequent column is the current column times 2. This gives us 1. 1 times 2 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16, and so on. Next, all we need to do is write the binary number below the numbers. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And then simply add the values of the columns with ones in them. 16 plus 4 plus 1 equals 21 decimal. Binary to decimal is really pretty simple. Next, let's convert from decimal to binary. This is slightly more complicated, but still not hard. We need to start with a binary column value larger than our decimal number. So we start at the right side with 1 and multiply by 2 until we have a number larger than what we want to convert. Then working from the left, we apply this rule. If the value we want to convert is greater than or equal to the column value, then we set a 1 for that column and subtract the column's value. Otherwise, we set a 0 for that column and continue. The result is then applied to the next column. And we apply the rule until we reach 0. So now let's try the earlier example of 21. First, find our columns. Start with 1 and double until we have a value greater than 21. Then start from the left and apply the rule. 21 is less than 32, so we write a 0 and move to the next column. 21 is greater than 16, so we write a 1 below the 16, subtract 16 from 21, leaving us 5. Next column. 5 is less than 8, so we write a 0 below 8 and move on. 5 is greater than 4, so we set a 1 below the 4 and subtract 4 from 5, leaving us 1. 1 is less than 2, so we set a 0 below the 2 and move on to the units. 1 is equal to 1, so we set a 1 in the units column, subtract 1 from 1, leaving us 0, and we're done! If we get to the end without reaching a 0, we've done something wrong and need to recheck our work. Looking at the binary value, we have 10101, which is what we saw in the previous example of binary to decimal. So it all works. Let's try 24 decimal as another example. 24 is greater than 16, So we set a 1 below the 16, subtract 16 from 24, leaving us 8. 8 is equal to 8, so set a 1 below this 8 and subtract 8, leaving us 0. Since we know 0 is less than all the other columns, we can just set them all to 0 and be done. This leaves us 11000 binary. And that's all there is to convert between binary and decimal. I've created a playlist over here that contains all the episodes in this series so far, and will be filled in as more are added. Thanks for watching, and if you learned something, I'd appreciate a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. I try to respond to all of them. So until next time, go make something. It doesn't have to be perfect, just have fun.